you know. And in that sense, I want to stress, maybe we forget sometimes because we are skeptic, but that it's a unique institution, you know, in the middle of the Arab world, in the middle of Islamic world. And I think it's very much called for, because for the sake of press freedom and good journalism, it's not a monopoly, you know, of some Western institutions. I was, of course, I had the same questions. I'm a journalist, but I'm a critical person myself. So I was so happy that the board assured me, you know, full freedom and full support.
Good morning. I work for the Peninsula newspaper. First of all, I'd like to congratulate and repress it. I'd like to know what you think of the new press law.
To add to my, you know, to the answer I gave to the previous question, and that is following that when I woke up this morning, you know, and I saw some new beginning of the center, I was happy because I thought, okay, I'm in the right. And frankly speaking, I don't also want, but in general speaking, it, as far as I understand, it's a proposal. It's a proposal for a law. And as any proposal, you know, it might have positive points and negative points. And of course, we are going to study, and we are going, and we hope that we will be invited at some point, you know, to join the debate. Well, as I said, our priority seminars before Ramadan. Having said that, there is also a pilot training for journalists from South Sudan, TV journalists and newspaper journalists will be it will be held at the end of April. So we will bring a group of journalists from this new country that still they haven't still declared independence, so they're very young and very vulnerable in the real media sector. So we try to support them by doing this training. It's kind of a pilot. You know, we are going to continue doing this, but we see this as a pilot. Because as I said, our priority is with Qatar. And at the end of this training, we will have a celebration for the 3rd of May, for the Press Freedom Day, and I mean, you will be invited, and we hope also to have some international guests, and of course, our Sudanese guests, participants in the training, will be there.